I think one of the best ways to learn about performance equations syntax is to use the Pi Point Builder for performance equations. Now, I know not all of you may have access to this, but those of you who are system managers or who have access to the Pi system management tools, I suggest you open this up. It's not critical, but it's just a nice tool. So you'd find that under All Programs, Pi System. This is called the Pi System Management Tools. And under that, we're going to go into the Point section to the Performance Equations Builder here. Now, this Performance Equation Builder allows me to enter certain performance equation expressions, like the one that you see right here. This performance equation expression uses a function, and this is a good starting point for our discussion of, you know, what types of functions are available from within performance equations. And that's the topic of our next section. There's a whole library of functions within performance equations that we're very proud of. These are functions that you would find that are very useful for folks in manufacturing. And these are functions you may not find in other applications. You certainly don't find them in Excel or Visual Basic or some of the common expression syntaxes. So for example, all of these functions, they have some very useful purposes for people who are looking at real-time data. Percent good, for example, will return the percentage of good data for a given period of time. So let me illustrate. I'll go ahead and bring up our performance equation syntax again, our performance equation parser here. Here we see percent good. We're looking for the amount of time, or the percentage of time during this last day, asterisk minus one day to the current time, that CDT 158 has been good. And when we evaluate this, we end up with 100%. So that's just one example of a function that's fairly useful in looking at real-time data. Some of the other functions are things like, what's the range of a process variable during a given period of time? What's the standard deviation, or the average, or the mean, or the max, the min, or the totalization during that same period? And then in addition to those, there are many, many other expression functions here. So if you look at this list here in our reference manual, you'll find all kinds of very useful functions, as I said, like percent good, functions that are kind of geared just towards real-time data. One of my favorites is, for example, time equals. I'll give you an example of that. If I would like to explain or to derive how long a given tag, for example, this digital tag, CDM158, let's see how long in the last, oh, let's say the last day shift, y plus 7 hours to y plus 15 hours. Let's see how long that's been equal to the word auto. This is going to return that value in seconds. So when I evaluate, it tells me for 6,600 seconds, this tag, CDM158, has been equal to the word auto, or to the digital state auto. So again, that's one very simple example. We have other functions available. You'll see all the, you know, the typical trig functions, sine, cosine, etc. Plus, as I mentioned, these things that are specific for working with real-time data. We also support an if-then-else structure. So for example, I can have an expression like this. If the value of sinusoid is greater than 50, then we'll say 1 else 0. We'll go ahead and evaluate this, and apparently the value of sinusoid is currently greater than 50. I have this if-then-else, and I can nest these if-then-elses together. So there's no artificial layer of depth that you have to go to for if-then-else. You can do it until you run out of space, basically. Now, sometimes when working with an if-then-else, well, you won't really need that else portion. You really just want an if-then. We do have a function called noOutput, which essentially ends up not changing whatever tag is involved. So there's going to be no output for that. So that's it on our discussion of performance equation functions and syntax. As I said, there is much more information that you'll find in the help file, PE reference. You'll find it in this directory right here. If you don't have that, there are instructions in your workbook on how to download that from our tech support website. So as we work with performance equation syntax in this class, remember, these are your resources to look up these functions, to understand how these functions work, etc., and see examples.